I don't know if I should have gone after Vanessa because she was so deep and inspirational. Yeah. I feel like so under pressure here to be on the same level. But you know what? I'm just going to speak from the heart because that's how I normally do things at school and here today. So my story began with Brian last year, May, and we met at my school. Very excited to be at my school. And I'm very excited to say that we even ended off at my school. It started off good and it ended off even better. Our partnership is a lot like a marriage. Anita used to always say this, the married couple is Melanie and Byron because they're always bickering in the corner. That was true, we were two naughty children that were sitting at the back of the room always gossiping and laughing. But we, in any marriage, you get good and you get bad. We at the dip right now. We are on a little bit of a lower, as you would put it. But unfortunately for Byron, he's stuck with me. He's partnered with me and he's got no choice. He's going to see this through with me, come hell or high water. I'm finishing this road with or without him. So I've spoken to Byron and I said to him, listen here, we've come so far. I can't give up now. This is not how I'm going to go down. So he agreed with me. We're going to continue this journey. We're going to carry on with this journey. But besides Byron, there's so many other people that I've met on this journey that has shown me so much, that I've learned so much from, and that I'm eternally grateful for. Gavin, Marcy, who's not here again, Brian, who's Gavin's brother, did you know that? Your brothers from another lifetime. Nasehu, Kim, Vanessa, and Judith, who came in a bit late to the program. I loved going to your school. It was an unbelievable experience. But beside Ram,
Heidi.
My brother in the back there used to drive me around and make sure I was safe so that I didn't have to drive alone. Morgan, thank you for everybody. And Shahadi, we've had such a nice group and such a bond that we've built with each other. And that was for me the highlight of this journey. But I think also all the training that we've been through, all the workshops that we've attended, it takes you to another level and it brings out a better lead in you. And that for me was what I wanted. I came into this program wanting to be a better leader, and I'm leaving being a better leader and a better person, because it takes you to places and it puts you on a different level. It makes you think differently about things. It makes you interact differently with people, and that for me was what I wanted. So I'm very grateful for this program. I'm very grateful for the long journeys that I've had to travel all by myself in the car, come home by myself in the car, and everybody was so concerned and worried that I reached home safely. It was a phenomenal journey. When I thought about my board and how I wanted to present it, I couldn't think of a better way but to portray us all as superheroes. And what I've done is, if you look through my comic strip that's there, each one of us has a hero inside of us, and we're all a superhero. For our principals out there, we put our cape on every day. Not that cape, a different cape, a hero cape. And we go to school and we face all those challenges every day. But because of programs like this, we are able to overcome it. We are able to pick up that phone and phone our business leader and phone our colleagues and phone our friends and say, what would you do? And you know what? We're all in the same boat. So we all have to learn from this and we all have to move forward. So I don't have much else to say besides I have a wonderful journey, Anita. You've been awesome with us. You've been patient and tolerant with us. We've been late so many times, but you've just carried on. So you are such an inspiration to us. I hope that we can continue the friendship more than anything else, because that's what's important to me. So please go through my comic strip and you'll see all our fun times that we've had together as a group. And you know, I love selfies, I love photos. There's lots of photos of all of you in here. I caught you all. There's a nice one of you in there.
Thank you, Melanie. Melanie is, the type of student that you have in your school that they never off one day. They never get sick. They participate in every type of sport that there is in the school. They don't just take six subjects. They take eight subjects in matric. That's the energy level that Melanie has. And this is something that I wanted to say about Melanie. She always put her hand up whenever, you know, we need a venue. I'm here. you know, we, you know, can you do this? You guys can come to my house, you can use my car, you can use my school, you know. So this is just the generosity. This is the word that I have for Melanie. Such a generous person. And yes, their partnership was actually beautiful, and like anything, it went through a bit of slump at one point. But yeah, Melanie wouldn't have any of this type of thing. Yeah. Die hard, she said. Okay, great. Thank you so much, Melanie. The next presentation is going to be by Judith and Masego. They have had such an interesting journey, and I'm so tempted to say something, but I'm not. So I will just welcome them to the front and let them tell us about their story. I'll just change the boards around.